Kyle, have you been playing Duke Nukem Forever?
No. You know, it's odd. I probably should have, because I was a huge fan of the old ones.
And I probably shouldn't have, because I didn't give a crap. Here's a better question for you.
Okay.
What is the video game industry's biggest broken promise? It means a game that we should have had by now, but has not been made.
Or at very least, it hasn't even been announced.
Hasn't even been announced.
Okay.
Nowhere do we know it's coming, but it should be.
Okay.
And we know it should be. And I say Kingdom Hearts 3, biggest broken promise.
Kingdom Hearts 3.
Squeenix, that's Square Enix for the you laymans out there, they have been teasing us with a new Kingdom Hearts game, a legitimate console Kingdom Hearts game, since 2.
And didn't they do a handheld at one point or
another? They have done all handhelds now. Like, that's all they do is the handheld ones. We're waiting for the one on PS3 and Xbox 360. But mostly PS3, because that's what we expect to come out next.
Right. I get you. As far as a broken promise?
Broken promise.
I don't know, Half-Life 2 Episode 3.
Never heard of it.
No, Half-Life 2 Episode 3 is a broken promise as far as I'm concerned. I played Half-Life 2, and I was good at it. They started doing the episodes, Half-Life 2 Episode 1, starting to sound kind of weird with a bunch of different numbers floating around, but the point, the absolute point of the episodic thing was so that they could pump them out faster, and so that they could give us more little versions of it. And then they only did 2, and it petered out. I want 3. They didn't give me 3. Instead, they decided, we're going to give you 3 in piecemeal.
So we have Episode 2, we have Part 1?
No.
Forget your explanation! Kingdom Hearts is more important right now. The first Kingdom Hearts, you follow around Sora. It was going to be Mickey Mouse, but you're not Mickey Mouse. The important thing is, at the end of the game, Mickey and Riku, the rival guy friend, get locked away in some random place we don't know where it is. So Kingdom Hearts 2 comes out and says, now we're going to tie up this story. So then they unlock everything. Everything is solved. It's a happy-go-lucky end. They get a note from Mickey saying they need help again.
Both of these games end on a cliffhanger. Mine is, spoiler, a death of a major character in a horribly gruesome fashion, and then a tease for a tie-in, a crossover, if you will, between Half-Life and Portal.
Okay.
Which people said, very simply, yes! Gotta have it. So what has Square Enix been up to since?
They desperately need a new game. Valve is doing fine. Squeenix needs something good to happen.
But I would argue that mine is a bigger broken promise for the opposite reason. Valve has been doing great games since they abandoned Half-Life to get sidetracked with Portal, which I love Portal. I'm a Portal fan. But Portal just took Valve and grabbed their head and yanked it right away.
You seem to be forgetting that Valve's top guy, Falco Lombardi.
That's an awesome name.
Yes. He has not broken any promises. He said they're going back to the Half-Life universe. They're gonna do it. And Portal 2 has an Easter egg on on the PS3 version and Xbox 360 version for that game that clearly says we're going back.
You can't even feasibly say that they're not going to make Kingdom Hearts 3. This is a Disney franchise.
This is also a Square Enix franchise. They don't know their ass from a hole in the ground.
But Disney is the money, and Disney says, you will make another game because we make trilogies around here.
And Squeenix is the game company and says, we don't know how to make games anymore. I don't even
know. Was that Italian or Japanese? I'm not sure.
They're one and the same now.
What? I think it's time to chug some Jones soda.
Yes. Dan, where's our Jones sodas?
What's up?
They didn't give us any this week, but we'll have some next week, I promise.
We've heard that before, Kyle.
We have heard that before. Another broken promise!
Squeenix and Dan have broken too many promises to us. We need a Kingdom Hearts 3, not just for Kingdom Hearts' sake, but for Squeenix's sake. Because if without Kingdom Hearts 3 to give them more money, they won't stay around any longer. We'll get no more games for them, period. And then I'll have to make the games, Kyle. I will. Me. And I don't know how to make games. And it's all Dan's fault!
Okay, I'm gonna give you an analogy here, Chris. You're talking about a Disney franchise. There will be a third one. I mean, let's put it this way. My game that I'm arguing, the Half-Life series, that's as if a faithful viewer of Lost...
You're out.
You chug water too fast.
I'm a water man. We're going to have to go to the points and refer to the judge.
Okay, judge's decision.
Dan is the judge.
Dan is the judge.
Neither of you win. Hate you guys.
I think we pissed off Dan.
We did. He's a little dejected.
So, just like Broken Promises, nobody wins.
Nobody wins.
Except for me.